Well, it's at that point that we pick it up, and we're joined this morning by Chief Eric Omafia, who is the President and Chief Executive Officer of Erisco Foods Limited. Thank you for coming out this morning, Chief.
Thank you very much.
Now, that Twitter absolute raised a lot of fears among so many people. There were several speculation concerning what exactly is happening to tomatoes in this country. I mean, you are a big player in this industry, and at that time, people just didn't know what to expect. But there were several occasions where you had said you had solutions to all of these problems. Could you tell us what happened at the time?
Thank you. Twitter absolute actually is the disease that have been ravaging tomatoes in my farms for some time now. For 3 years now I've been there. And
3 years?
Yeah, 3 years. Farming season years now. Most people don't know because we have been searching on it. And after the second year, the second one, we sent back our research to improve on the seeds and tested last year. None of our farmer was affected. And we made it known to people that this absolute has solution actually. But for the fact that we are not yellow colored people and we don't believe on our own thing, it's happening to everywhere. And for the fact that cabas and civil servants don't want to hear us solving the problem of Nigeria here because probably from some extra code or some any other benefits. This thing that is happening now could have been controlled if they have had what we have been saying before, that there's need for farmers and off-takers to work together and solve this problem of our food security in this country. But we are being punished for trying to help this country to grow. That's corrupting before this government coming.
Being punished.
Yeah.
For trying
to help this nation. We Erisco Foods are being punished for attempting to do that.
How?
They supported importation than the local manufacturing. That is correct. See, this moment I'm talking to you, civil servant, quality of the Minister of Trade, have never known what they are doing. Don't care to know. They tell us, are you sure? Now that is supporting importation? How can a country like this be talking of import now by this century? We are self-sufficient in Nigeria. In as a nation, the food we are being again being colonized.
Are we self-sufficient in tomatoes?
Yeah, should be by now. Tomatoes, actually, the problem that the last previous two harvesting season, the farmers lost big money. Was 5% of tomato farming in this country are wasted, so they run away. By the last season, only few farmed, and there was 2,000 again. The shortage was there. Heavily. But the other year, because they found more, the shortage wasn't much. Now people run away before it comes. No matter what they're telling you, we know tomato in this country better than all, including ministry that is in charge of it. You except know, that of federal minister of agriculture. I have respect for him because he's trying to know what they are doing.
Let me ask, because if you say 3 years ago there was this pest. Actually, they say it's not a disease, it's pest infestation.
Yeah.
So it's a pest that comes on the tomato called Twitter
absolute.
And you say you have carried out some research to see how you can stop
we've done
the
that,
pest from coming. And you've
perfected
it.
And done, come this year, our farm will continue to, right now I'm going to
those,
produce.
Those who helped in the, you know, taking care of the infestation of the pest on tomatoes, are they also Nigerians?
Pardon?
Those who helped in stopping
no, no, no,
the
no,
spread.
It's combined.
It's a combined
yes,
team.
Yes, I shall get the team aside.
So it's a combined team.
Yes.
Did you also send some kind of a report to the Minister of Agriculture on that?
Well, until you, he who is buying, asking how much. Not he who is buying, who is selling. You ask me how much, then how much I'm selling. Anyway, I made the effort to get to them, but because of my previous experience, Honorable Minister of Agric is ready to help this country anytime, any day. I can confirm that to you.
Tell us about your previous experience.
My?
What do you mean, your previous experience?
Where NAFDAC of Nigeria made research on all tomato pests in this country. Came out with 91.1% are fake, substandard, not good for consumption. 15 months down the line, no action has been taken.
91.1%
on documents.
NAFDAC
themselves, automotive pest imported from China. And to confirm it all, when we went to trip with Mr. President last China,
Our minister confronted them. Why are you dumping tomatoes in Nigeria? Why? Dumping fake product in Nigeria? They said, no, we have good product. It's you greedy people, businessmen in Nigeria, come to request for less quality.
They said that?
Yes. He said that man, our minister of health, minister of that, they never do it. To this moment, nothing is happening. How can we allow people to come and dump here, frustrate us, make us operate less than our capacity, while the factory we have here, fourth largest in the world, is bigger than world where they're importing from China. And we are happy, proud to kill ourselves in this country. We cannot help this economy to grow. Later we say, President, we have good intention, but we cannot help Nigeria alone. Only we will combine to make this country to grow and make it to be great. But we, as a human being, will start from us.
Because I think it's time. I'm happy that we're talking about this because it was only recently we had a conversation with the governor of Akwa Ibom State, and he talked about the difficulty. That's a state government that they try to bring in some seedlings, some palm seedlings, and how much the government agency asked them to pay. So if on one hand, we're saying we want to grow Nigerian produce by Nigeria idea and philosophy, and on the other hand, you say they still try to frustrate the process.
Deputy, in the area I am, the cabals call foreigners, China, India, and Lebanese, they control the tomato paste importation to this country. And they told us, when we went to the manufacturing meeting, they told me, you can't stop us. We are stronger than you. And I see the sitting in it now.
Chief, they told you?
They told me in the meeting. I told them, we better go to Pakistan integration in this country. They told me, no, it's Boko Haram area. But I go there, they have more than 2,000 staff marketing their own product imported. But to manufacture in the north is Boko Haram area. But another money is good, not Boko Haram money, but the product is to manufacture is Boko Haram. See how they are thinking this. And our people, our government people that should control them, connive, compromise with them, and is telling me that I'm angry for this country. We have enough work to give to our people in this country. Many, we don't need to say we have no work. It's telling me that our labor minister, we say we have 20 million graduates, that has no work. While 1.5 million illegal workers are working in Nigeria, Indians, Chinese, no documents.
I can see your pain, but what's the way out of this?
Government will come and work with our people, not to work with foreigners. Foreigners deceive them, and they believe them. They thought this one Nigeria was small. Now we are capable. We have facilities, the text. We have gone to technology, but our own people, we like to deal with them. For the reason best known to them, you can't believe it that only presidency, CBN, giving us little support.